60 years ago today, President John F. Kennedy was assassinated as he rode in a motorcade through downtown Dallas, Texas. He was 46 years old. The Warren Commission investigated the shooting and found that Lee Harvey Oswald was the lone gunman, firing a total of 3 shots. With the help of modern science, the Knott Laboratory disputes those findings.
Joining us now to discuss this is Stanley Stoll. He's the CEO and principal engineer at Knott Laboratory. Good morning. Thanks
Good morning.
For being with us.
Good morning.
So tell us what the technology is that your company has that recreated the scene of what happened on that day.
Yeah, the technology is laser scanners. So going through the process of scanning Dealey Plaza and creating an exact replica of Dealey Plaza and then reconstructing that back to 1963 state. So
and that's what we're looking at here?
That's what you're looking at there.
So how did you do it? You use portions of the Zapruder film and then you use scientific measurements?
Yeah, we overlay the Zapruder film and other photographs over the top of the reconstructions, the point cloud that was collected out there in the on Dealey Plaza.
Yeah, and it's my understanding that a bullet can do strange things in a body. And you claim that there had to be more than one shot for Connally and JFK. But I think the Warren Commission said that when you look at the Zapruder frame, they are both reacting simultaneously to one shot. So what is your counter to that?
Yeah, the information that we have is just taking and putting back together where John F. Kennedy and Governor Connally were located in that limousine, and then looking at the bullet wounds from the autopsy and the evidence that sits in the National Archives. And when we put those exactly back into the point cloud, we can't make those align to create one bullet. That's really the big thing that we've discovered through our investigation.
So, yeah, I think that's what we're seeing here. So here is the trajectory, this green line here. Explain this. And Governor Connally, you say if this was that one bullet, he would have to be situated a little bit further to the left. Is that correct, how you see it move here?
That's correct. That green line is the entrance and exit wounds on President Kennedy from the autopsy. And then the red line is correlating with the wounds of Governor Connally, the entrance in his back and then out through his lower chest and then ultimately embedding in his left thigh. And we have to slide him to the inside to get those alignments anywhere close to working with a single bullet, which is not accurate for the actual, you know, reconstruction of the scene and putting them exactly where they were at that time in 1963.
But doesn't that theory assume that the bullet must travel in a perfectly straight line like a laser?
We're just doing straight lines on that. But as far as the bullet, the wounds themselves, there's also different trajectories. So if you look at that red line that was showed there in the display, that's also coming from a right to left angle. And so the bullet has to come out of President Kennedy, jump over to the right and come back from a right to left angle to make something like that work. So as shown right there, we can't get this anywhere close. There could be something that works if you slide Governor Connally to the inside, talking to your point, Larry, about how, you know, a bullet does funny things in bodies and everything like that. But you have to slide him to the inside to get that exit wound close to the exit wound of President Kennedy, close to the entrance wound of Governor Connally.
Okay, so let's say for the sake of argument, you have evidence of a second bullet. You have evidence of a second shooter and a second shooting location.
We don't. All we wanted to do, and all the analysis has done so far, is build this model and evaluate the single bullet theory. So we've gotten to that point. So now next steps are to start to figure that out. There's more to the story is basically what we're saying. You've got to start evaluating more.
Sure.
Is the government interested in your research?
We don't know yet. We've just published these findings and kicked this out in with the 60th anniversary coming up and all of the interest that's generated around it. We hope that we can contribute to the greater investigation at the government level.
Well, Stanley, thanks for being with us. For more information, you can check out knottlab.com.
Thank you, Stanley.
Thank you very much.